What's up?
All right. Yeah, so I just wanted to respond to the question about the Randall cycle.
Okay.
Because there's a few people on the internet right now that have YouTube channels that are talking about the Randall cycle, and that's what's they're claiming that that's what's made America fat because we all eat a mixed diet. And part of me agrees with this because, yes, we've, you know, a diet that is mixed is hyperpalatable. However, personally, I've tried very low carb diets. I've tried very low fat diets, and I feel awful on both. And so for me, a diet with like meat and potatoes and fruit and vegetables with about 30% protein, 30% fat, and 40% carbs, that's where I feel best. And I can control my...
Let me ask you a question.
Yeah.
What kind of meat are you eating and how much added fat do you have? Because I feel like unless you're eating very lean meats, it would be fairly easy to hit 30% fat without adding fat to your diet, without adding added oils.
Well,
it's from butter and olive oil and stuff that's added in.
Sure. I mean, I don't really add a lot of fat to my meats. It's mostly just like steak and
not to the meat, but to the other foods like the vegetables and the potatoes. Like, are you adding like butter to the potato and olive oil to the vegetables?
Only a tiny bit. I don't really. I can eat them.
So most of your fat is in the natural foods, right?
Correct. Yeah.
Yeah. Look, I mean, there's. I just think that the. I think, like I said before, I think the theory. I guess you're asking a little bit more about the practical question of what's good to do now. I think the theory is just wrong. Like it's. Randall cycle addresses why you would have elevated fatty acids or glucose, because if you're out competing, if your fatty acids are out competing glucose, you're going to have hyperglycemia, or you're going to require more insulin than you'd otherwise require to bring that glucose into the cells, and vice versa, right? So you're more likely to have circulating energy supplies in your blood due to poor tissue uptake. When you're consuming these things together, you're more likely to be more dependent on a higher insulin response. That's primarily related to the metabolic outcome. It doesn't mean that mixing them causes diabetes. It just means that there is more substrate competition, and all things equal, if one person's on the edge of diabetes, if two people are right on the edge of diabetes and one eats a mixed diet, there's a higher probability that they're going to go over that edge because of the substrate competition contributing to the hyperglycemia and the greater insulin requirement than someone who's on a low carb or low fat diet. But that doesn't mean that a mixed diet is bad or that it's not optimal for you. So first of all, if you have no evidence of metabolic dysfunction on a mixed diet, then there's no issue. Second of all, getting fat like that, that's kind of the same error that the sort of Tobbsian carb-centric view of body fat gain is making, which is the idea that the glycemic response or the insulin is going to be what makes you fat, when actually the caloric balance is what makes you fat. And you know that like there's a little bit of truth in the carb-centric or the carbohydrate hypothesis of obesity. There's an element of truth in that some people are going to have blood sugar dysregulation on a carb-heavy diet that leads them to eat more food because their blood sugar fluctuations are so great that hyperinsulinemia is driving them to eat more. Like there's probably a subset of people for whom that's a factor, but overwhelmingly, that is not the main cause of obesity. And to say the Randall cycle is the cause of obesity is making the exact same error, because it's focusing on the glycemic response and the insulin response instead of the overall caloric balance. What makes you fat is eating too much food. You know, the only thing that you should change about the calories in, calories out hypothesis on a practical level is to say that it tells you very little about the behavioral modifications that someone needs to make to sustain a caloric deficit over time. And so you must have, you must engage with what are the possible effects of all those diets, plus all the habits and lifestyle and mindsets and everything that plays into eating behavior. All of that exists, and it causes nuance. And then nutrient partitioning is affected by protein and exercise in a way that says, for any given caloric balance, how much goes into fat storage, how much goes into muscle building. Other than that, like that's it, right? So why do people get fat? I don't think we need to hash out the whole thing here. Like I'll just largely endorse Stefan Guillen's view. It's basically the proliferation of hyperpalatable food. A mixed diet leverages the principle of creating a hyperpalatable diet by mixing carbs and fat, but your diet doesn't sound hyperpalatable. You're not telling me, you know, like compare what you're eating to what to an Oreo cookie. Okay, the Oreo cookie is saying, I need this amount of sweetness, I need this amount of creaminess, I need this amount of crunch, I need this amount of like, take out a little bit of bitter in this compound, like just mix it together to make you eat more. Or Lay's potato chip has the carb, the fat, and the salt in just the right proportion, and the mouthfeel and the texture, the baking temperature, the glycation products with a little browning to make you bet you can eat just one. It's not like the percent carbs and fat that's doing that. It's the way that they're combined. It's the mouthfeel. It's the texture. It's the salt. It's the ratios. It's that stuff. Like eating the natural fats of meat with vegetables with a small amount of fat added will bring the percent up, but it's just not hyperpalatable.
Yeah. Thank you for that. And I'm just going to say one more thing. I agree with that 100%. And the couple people that are parroting this idea that the Randall cycle causes obesity are completely ignoring the hyperpalatability aspect. And they're just saying that it's the mixing of fat and carbs and the competition and the Randall cycle. That's why I wanted to bring this up.
Yeah, way off. All right, thanks, man.
Thank you.